What's going on, you guys? This is your girl Ty, singer-songwriter with Reflective Music, and we are back with another episode of The Craft. Yes, we are. Now, if this is your very first time watching The Craft, what we do is we recognize local artists, so it's not just artists, it's chefs, it's lyricists, it's tattoo artists, it's clothing line people, it's all of that the above. If you have a talent, we just want to recognize local talent. They don't get recognized enough, right? Right. And so today we have a phenomenal woman. You guys, she does it all. She does tattooing. She does paints. She paints. She has a clothing line. She's a lyricist. She just does it all. You hear me? We are interviewing Vavi today, and we are actually here at a local spot. Local heroes, you guys. We're at Hawthorne Mall right now in Vernon Hills. You know, so you can come out and check this out. But right now, what we're gonna do, we're gonna go ahead and head inside so we can go ahead and we can see what this phenomenal woman is all about. Y'all ready? I'm ready. Let's go. Guys, so I am here with the lovely, the phenomenal Vavi. How you doing, boo?
I'm good.
Good.
I'm
You're great. Looking all glowy and sunshiny. Just I'm living your life like you're going. Yes, baby. Yes, I love the vibes. Now, you have a multitude of names, right? So I'm gonna need you to explain some of that because I just say Vavi.
Well, so, Vavi is I've been Vavi since my dad named me that. When I first dove into creativity,
okay,
I began taking on different personas that fit the theme, fit the time of my life, the chapter. So people who ride with me back, I say 2010, they may know me as Vavi Crude.
Oh.
Vavi Crude was something that I embodied because crude meant raw, unedited.
Okay.
And I wanted that to strictly be my whole persona because at that point, I don't think Instagram was popping yet.
I think
you're
still doing MySpace. Yeah, I think
so. That was my first time creating a website. So on my website, it was like a digital diary. So come there and expect only me. Don't box me in.
Right.
Vavi Crude. I played my hand in that for a good, about 7 to 10 years, I'd say.
All right now.
Yeah.
You have longevity in this. Yeah. Okay.
Went into art shows and galleries and, you know, really just finding my own as the artist that I wanted to be.
Okay.
And I recently tried my hand in tattooing.
All right.
And that's how some people know me as Tattoo Yogi.
Oh, okay. So we have Tattoo Yogi now.
Tattoo Yogi is also a persona of mine. And these personas are not, you know, for the sake of, oh, I want to be, it just was fitting the theme of my life. I was very into yoga. Pregnancy took me into that.
Okay.
And, tattooing was something that I actually studied for 5 years behind closed doors.
Okay.
But the pandemic happened.
Oh, honey.
So I found the confidence to find something that I could still do comfortably and choose my environments, choose the people I was around, which, okay, you know, pressed me into more purpose because I've already wanted to do it, but I was too scared.
So you said you got into the tattooing with the pandemic. Now, how was that for you?
It was liberating. Be honest, I felt like it was a silver lining to the pandemic for me. And okay, I know a lot of other creatives that might feel this way, but I don't think if the pandemic didn't happen, that I wouldn't have tried tattooing the way I did. I went very head first, all in. I didn't do anything else, strictly tattooing and painting occasionally, but not even. And I found my confidence as a more in-depth entrepreneur that way. Because I had to I had to run a business at that point. It was very different from just being an artist. I was a business person, businesswoman at that point. So it taught me a lot.
All right. So let's see. So we have your art, we have tattooing. Let's talk about the clothing. Because we have a lovely sweater right here designed by Ms. Vavi herself.
Yes.
And I love the sweater, actually. So let's dive into this real
quick. This is a very popular sweater, thanks to the local girls pop-up shop. This happened now maybe 2.5 years ago.
Okay.
And she was bought. She's actually a commissioned piece. But thankfully, the person who purchased this is a good friend of mine. And she supports me so much that she wants me to keep it and it to be seen.
Nice.
So okay. That's why I haven't sold it. A lot of people are mad at me because I won't sell it to them. I'm like, it's bought already.
Right.
You know, but I do have commissions open to make others. So if they want to pay for one, they
look,
can have
I may. We may talk out there.
I said to my friend, I said, what if we get to ask you if I can rock your hoodie that you bought? She was like, why wouldn't you?
Right.
It was one of them shrinking moments. I didn't own my gifts, so I wore it and I found a way to get to one of her background singers by the end of the concert, and he took a picture, sent it to her, and let me know later that she saw it, and that was like a big accomplishment for me because I love Vavi.
Of course, you of know? Course. Now you said he.
Yes.
Okay, so
yes.
I love the Vavi. She is, hey mama, yes. Hey girl. Now, you said he, so was it Duran?
I wish it was Duran.
Girl, can I was gonna say, hold on, wait.
I love
that's
Duran.
A whole different story.
But Duran and Taryn were actually walking side by side, and I think Duran had it by the end of the night. He was trying to go, and luckily, Taryn looked behind, like, and he came over,
okay.
And I got to tell him, like, look what I did. I did this spin. And he basically turned on the camera and said, talk to her.
Very nice. Ooh,
yeah, so it was meant for it to be him because I don't
hello.
Think Taryn had the patience for
me. Yeah, he was probably
there. he was definitely there for the night.
Now, but, what you guys don't know, I got actually introduced to Vavi from a musical standpoint.